Hi friends, I am with a leisurely personality and I am so honored and so blessed to be with Dr. Lalit Kanodia. Lalit Kanodia is a very, very well-known figure in the business world. He himself is a management PhD, studied in US, and he is the first person to be invited by Tata to lead TCS. And after years of experience, today he is leading IMC, that is Indian Merchant Chambers. And I'm so very blessed to be with him in Sri Lanka on the delegation. So let's have some chat with him. So welcome, Dr. Kanodia.
Thank you.
And can you just throw some light of your entire journey, your education, and what you did all these years?
Well, I was educated at IIT Bombay, second batch that joined the institute and the first batch on the campus in Powai. And then fortunate enough to get admitted to MIT, which is considered to be the Mecca for all engineers. And then fortunate again to head the class there and therefore was awarded the Ford Foundation Fellowship. And then, of course, I went on to get my PhD, again from the same institute. And was fortunate enough to have been invited by Tata's to start and head what is now the most valuable company in their fold, which is Tata Consultancy Services. So I've enjoyed it. It's been an interesting journey, and I've enjoyed every minute of it.
And you have developed various businesses, and today you are at a juncture where you have just revealed to me that you are 77 years young. I never call anybody old, and when I meet a person like you, who is with full of spirit, full of enthusiasm, and so very committed at this age to do something for people. So tell us about your business also.
Well, I've been fortunate to have been able to start several companies, which all of whom are doing well, relatively speaking. We have DATAMATICS Global Services, which is a company which do the software field. And we have a BPO enterprise, Business Process Outsourcing Enterprise. We have a financial services company called DATAMATICS Financial Services. We have an HR consulting company called DATAMATICS Staffing Services. The family has put up a fertilizer plant near Durgapur at Panagad, which is the largest single stream urea plant in the country today. And the family runs an airline out of St. Louis, the feeder airline, there were 100 planes. So we've been blessed, I think. We've been also lucky. And I've enjoyed every minute of what I've done.
So as Henry Ford says, harder you work, luckier you get. So you must have put in a lot of hard work. In fact, without that, you cannot do your PhD. Now, incidentally, we are sitting in a Tata enterprise, that is Taj Samudra in Colombo. So what are your memories with Tata's?
I have very pleasant memories of Tata's and I owe my career to them. I've been fortunate at a very young age, relatively speaking, to have known almost every Tata director at that time, including G.R.D. Tata, Naval Tata, almost every single one of them. And I have very, very good memories of them. They're very, very professional people. No-nonsense attitude, give a lot of liberty to their managers. And that's one of the reasons why they've done so well. So I always say that I owe my entire career to my grounding in Tata's.
Now that you are heading IMC, Indian Merchant Chambers, so which is now rebranded as IMC Chamber of Commerce and Industries. So what is IMC and what is your vision for IMC now?
See, IMC is one of the oldest chambers of commerce in the country. It's 111 years old. Is the only chamber of which Mahatma Gandhi was a member. He accepted membership only of IMC and of no other chamber.
That's amazing.
Yes. The foundation stone of our building, which is opposite Churchgate Station, was laid by none other than Sardar Patel. Pandit Nehru, our first Prime Minister, has come to the chamber four times. Almost every President and Prime Minister of India have addressed our chamber, including Mr. Modi has addressed us twice. So I think being situated in the commercial capital of India IMC is all about business and trade and industry. We are blessed, and I think IMC has a tremendous role to play in future. And I'm confident that given the leadership that is now evolving, IMC will more than achieve the goal that is set for itself. So I'm very fortunate to have been elected as president of IMC, unopposed, and I'm enjoying every minute of it.
Of course, person of your stature should also always be elected as unopposed. Earlier you were mentioning about two of our active members who are in the cabinet. So who are they and what portfolios they are holding now?
See, we've been very fortunate to have very distinguished people lead our committees. Today we have 46 committees in the chamber, and they are the ones who really do the day-to-day work of the chamber. Two of the past chairmen have been Suresh Prabhu, who is now Minister of Industries and Commerce, and the other person who was heading one of our committees is Mr. Piyush Goyal. So I think we are very fortunate to have had that caliber of leadership. And the very fact that two of them have reached the very top speaks for itself. So that way we are very fortunate. We are very, very committed and very excellent people who are heading our committees even today.
So last 3 days we have been here in Sri Lanka meeting various business organizations, few ministers and some officials. So what is your overall experience with Sri Lanka?
Well, I was pleasantly surprised at what Sri Lanka has been able to do. As all of you know, we became independent on the 15th of August 1947, and they became independent just a few months later in February 1948. We started with the same platform in a way, and today, if you look at various parameters, I think they have done brilliantly well, and something which I think we need to learn from them. For example, the per capita income is now twice that of India. For example, our literacy rate is 70%, their literacy rate is 95%. The level of cleanliness, you've been traveling all over the city, is far higher than that of India. So I think they've done very well. And as somebody very correctly put it, we have many neighbors, but Sri Lanka has only one neighbor, and that neighbor is India. And I think we really need to establish a much closer contact with Sri Lanka, which is going to benefit both our nations. One good example is the USA and Canada. The bilateral trade between those two countries is $500 billion a year. It's unbelievable, $500 billion a year. We should aspire to learn from them, and they should aspire to learn from us. If that happens, I think it'll be a win-win situation.
So, Doctor, it is phenomenal talking to you. Just last question. Now, you are still young, but still, my question to you is, we as the next generation and the generations which have come after that, that is my kid generation. In fact, today I say that in my family there are three generations, because the difference of 7 years between my two kids, and it's actually feel like a difference of generation. So what would be your the wisdom that you want to share with them?
I think your generation and my generation went through a fairly difficult time. As all of you know, the rate of development of India was lower than the world average till 1991. Post-1991, I think we have developed very rapidly. And as Prime Minister Modi said in Davos in 1997, our GDP was $400 billion. And today is $2.5 trillion. Which means it has increased by a factor of 6. So I think we've laid, your generation and my generation have laid a platform which can launch the next generation. In a way, they're blessed, and if they're capable, and if the country allows them the latitude, which I hope they will, they can accomplish the impossible. Because we are a very talented people. We have all the opportunity, we have the legacy, the history supporting us, and now we have the economic platform to launch. I hope they proceed forward as rapidly as possible.
Thank you, Dr. Kanodia. Thank you for your generosity and your kindness. And friend, he is a phenomenal personality. I would recommend that each and every person who's aspiring to do big in life, should meet Dr. Kanodia. the knowledge that he has, the wisdom that he has, if we just have, you know, spend few minutes with him, I'm sure we won't be the same person and we will propel ahead in life. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.